En su cuenta de Twitter escribió: me llamó el presidente Donald Trump para responder a la solicitud que le hicimos sobre la adquisición de ventiladores y equipo médico de terapia intensiva.
Okay, so in this video I just wanted to bring it into attention because it is connected with Mexican and American politics, and especially with the coronavirus. Mexico's President AMLO, which is Andrés Manuel López Obrador, contacted Donald Trump through telephone lines soliciting that he could receive or be able to buy ventilators and medical equipment such as for intensive therapy. It doesn't go into specifics what he's buying from the United States, but the point is that they accepted to sell these medical equipment to Mexico in this desperate times, which is pretty cool. It's a pretty good sign of faith from the both countries. It shows that they want to work together. It honestly does. Let's see, let's go on a little bit more forward.
En otro mensaje, añadió: me garantizó que a finales de este mes tendremos 1,000 y podremos adquirir otros más, porque nuestro país no tiene restricciones para las compras de equipo de Estados Unidos.
Okay, so AMLO said that, I'm pretty sure he's talking about Trump, so he says that Trump gave him a guarantee that at the end of this month that we are going to have 1,000, okay, so at the end of this month, he's going to be able to receive 1,000 of the medical equipment, because it doesn't say what he's going to receive, and in the next, and that he's going to be able to get more because our country, Mexico, is not restricted with the United States on buying equipment from the United States. So there's no, I'm guessing there's no tariffs, is what he's trying to say.
Finalmente escribió: es un nuevo gesto de solidaridad con México. Le planteé la posibilidad de encontrarnos en junio o julio para encontrarle personalmente, con extenderle también personalmente nuestro.
And right there, AMLO just says that it is a new, it's like a new, like a new friendship with Mexico, that this is being done, because I'm telling you, this is like a desperate time, coronavirus. I mean, they need the respiratories, they need their equipment in the United States. It has a wider expansion outbreaks than Mexico. But AMLO notices this, and that he wants to show him his gratitude, and he wants to give him his personal testimony also to the entrance of the T-MEC, which was finally finalized. So this is basically showing AMLO's in good faith, he's trying to be like a good person. Well, not even a good person. What I'm trying to say is that they're trying to create a good relationship. You know what I mean? They're trying to build a good relationship, which they're doing, especially in these times. You know, every country would be very grateful if you get help with medical equipment to save its people, right? So let's go on to the next one. All right, and for those that are, on my channel for immigration types topics, Guatemala stops all deportations from the United States due to the coronavirus, which is actually a pretty smart move. Think about it. America has a lot of infected, you know what I mean? It's a real tragic thing, honestly, because China was supposed to be like the major, major infection site. That was, you know, the hotspot. But now it's America. So the government of Guatemala has blocked all flights of deportations of immigrants from the United States in a chance to just stop this propagation, or la propagación, which is the expansion of the coronavirus in the Central American country. This is a fun fact for you guys as well. This is like a, yeah, this is a cool one. On to the next video. In this video, where two people were tested for coronavirus, came out positive, and then escaped the hospital. So one, they're missing, and barely one was caught like a few hours ago, but there's still one on the loose, which is basically a porter. Here, just.
Decenas de agentes policiales participaron a lo largo del día en la ubicación de estos guatemaltecos quienes dieron positivo para coronavirus. Las máximas autoridades de la PNC giraron instrucciones a los oficiales de todas las comisarías del país.
So they just said right now that they started looking for them, and that the state even sent a statewide, countrywide message, you know, to everyone that's in as a police, as special agent, to be careful with cases like this and to start looking for any people that have coronavirus. Because I'm believing that they think that they're all going to try to escape because it's scary. You know what I mean? They're going to get the COVID-19. If they test positive, they're going to try to escape. Because a lot of people are being quarantined by the hospitals. And some of them, which a lot of them actually, usually die in the hospitals. So it's pretty messed up.
Sin embargo, en poco tiempo se dio con el primer resultado positivo.
Luego, inmediatamente se localiza una de estas dos personas y ahora se está en búsqueda de la otra.
So, what they're saying right now is that they were tested for coronavirus, and then one of them escaped the hospital. Well, they both escaped the hospital, but one of them was captured a few hours later. Unfortunately, they are high risk because they could infect other people, and they're on the search for the last person that's infected in Guatemala. This is in Guatemala.
Donde aparentemente lo han ubicado. Las unidades son específicamente de agentes de Policía Nacional Civil, con mascarilla, con guantes y en todo momento una coordinación estrecha con el Ministerio de Salud para poder venir y ubicar a esta persona y llevarla nuevamente a...
All right, so what they're saying is that what he's adding on is that they're bringing more police units and that they're giving them the necessary equipment, which are gloves, masks, sanitizers, cleaning agents. So when they do capture this man, or if they do find him, they could bring him back and quarantine him. All right, let's on to the next one. Another quick news: a meat factory closes because 293 employees test positive for coronavirus. This happened in South Dakota, at Smithfield's Foods. It was a plant at Sioux Falls in South Dakota. 300 people tested positive for coronavirus. Unfortunate, very unfortunate. Also related to the video, also related to this episode, Prince Harry and Meghan were giving food out in Los Angeles to the sick with their N95 masks and the gloves, of course. You know, they're royalty still. They can't just let anyone touch them. Well, that's not even funny. Actually, I just wanted to say that thank you to these people, because that's pretty nice of them. They actually donated food and were helping through the Project Angel Food down there in Skid Row, which I know of. I used to work down there selling Obama phones to a bunch of homeless people. Sorry. So that's a little fun fact for you guys to know about. That happened. Latino lawmakers call for farm workers to be shielded from deportation during the pandemic. So in this article, I'm going to just give you guys a little opinion when I'm done. Latino lawmakers on Wednesday asked Democratic and their Republican congressional leaders to include protections for the nation's farm workers in the next coronavirus relief package, urging them to grant agricultural laborers additional economic support as well as temporary reprieve from deportation for those without legal status, as workers who are critical to the nationwide response to the deadly pandemic, which has killed more than 26,000 people in the U.S., undocumented farm workers should be shielded from immigration enforcement until Congress places them on a pathway towards legalizing their status. 36 lawmakers in the Congressional Hispanic Caucus said in a letter to the top Democrats and Republicans in the House and the Senate. This is actually important that shouldn't be looked at lightly. We have a lot of Mexican workers out there, Latinos, so I won't just generalize Mexicans. We have a lot of Latino workers out there that are still trying to work because they're not, some of them, like they say, are undocumented and they're not going to receive help from the government, which means that they are still trying to go to work, put food on the table for a lot of Americans as well as theirs, because they're working in a dignified manner. And it just sucks to me that they're not going to be able to get any help only because they're undocumented, which is not even like I'm sorry that I'm underlining only, because they're illegal. And that really does mean that they can't get any help from us because they're illegal. They're not on the United States head. Because we're just trying to help the citizens and whoever's illegal. See, in this one, I want to give my opinion, because there is a lot of people out there that think the worst. But in this case, I have to give my honest opinion. I have a cousin and an uncle here that are farm workers, and they are mayordomos. My uncle used to be a mayordomo. My cousin is a real mayordomo. So what a mayordomo is he's a boss on the fields. Like, he brings people with him to the fields to work the plantations or the vegetables, whatever plant. Some of these people are undocumented, honestly, and it's highly likely in the United States there's a lot of undocumented farm workers. If you put to the idea of these farm workers working, these people are the ones that are putting a lot of vegetables and, you know, food in the markets. They're working for the American economy. You know, they're putting food for us. So I know that it's a little bit blunt to say this, but they should be able to get some relief. Like, honestly, it sucks that they're illegal. It really does, but they should get some type of relief because we're all humans, and I do believe that if they're helping the United States in some way, we should at least give them a little bit of money. Or not even a little bit of money, just protection from the enforcement. Like, honestly, if we could just give them protection for now because of this coronavirus, that would be awesome. Give me your opinion. Give me your thoughts on what I just said right now. And that's about it, guys. Honestly, this has been a good video. I'm still trying to make more videos. So I'll catch you later. Catch me on Instagram. And for now, good luck and stay safe and stay tuned, guys. Later.